Hotel Casino Complex, which is the Crystal Palace. You won't miss it, because if you love colors, you can't beat the colors that you see. And this is the newest one, which is the Crystal Palace.
I have no despair about the future. Yeah, I believe it does. Okay, now you can act. Here we are.
Here we are at the Stingray Pool, Amy and Eddie. Where the sun's going down.
Yep.
Look at these fishies.
Yeah.
Here, I don't know if
you can. There he is. He likes me, that one.
This is the
combo.
Right,
so I
get
a
seat. Oh, it's
the combo. The game is worth the.
That's it.
Yes, that's a call.
She's coming live on camera.
Okay, Captain,
right,
you gotta move.
There's something here.
Besides the eyes and the mouth, you get everything else.
Oh, yeah.
It's more, I think it's more important to stay. Only on the page for it.
That's hard.
Mm.
Yeah. Okay.
It's like another type of cucumber. When you pick him out of the water, he shoots.
Shoots at you?
Yeah.
Watch it now. He might wet you, so turn him, you know.
No, turn him like this. What'd you shoot?
Squeeze him a little.
I'm not gonna squeeze him.
Where to have the sharks at 1 o'clock? Is that where the sharks are? Do you help feed them now over this one?
Yes. They must have a lot of food.
Which one?
See his eyes sticking out the top. Two big eyes, the big shell.
There he goes.
We have a lot of fishermen, and what they do, the restaurant, they probably make a deal, you know, with some fishermen, and you know, they could get them at a good price.
Is it like there?
So many.
Yeah,
it feels
that
place.
The chowder.
Oh!
It's chowder. Chowder.
Every day. Every day?
Oh, yes.
It is delicious.
Here comes another one.
The big ones over here.
Big ones.
Ooh, you can feel that one thing.
When are they going to speed it?
I think 1 o'clock.
1 o'clock?
These guys get fed at 11?
These guys get fed at 11?
All together makes it easier.
This may be some of their food left over from 11.
You can go around that way. That's where those men are going.
There were born here in captivity at Coralville, just going to Lodge in Tangu, January 17, 1988. Right? They were the first ones ever born here in captivity. They're going to be the first. That's one thing about sharks. You can take them on any environment and set them in another.
These are the ones you can beat.
These are the ones that you're going to see through the pen with the large ones. At 1 o'clock, and then you can come back here and pet them later on, because someone will be inside and will take one out so you can get a closer count. Okay? They feed them at the same time.
No, the feeding time is not at this time. We feed them twice a week at a different time where they get different types of fish. But I just brought these today to demonstrate how they feed. Okay, before I start, I just caution everybody, please, not to put their hands in the water while you're feeding them. And they may mistake your hand for a handout, and we wouldn't like that to happen. Okay, and for those of you who have children with you, please make sure that they keep their hands out of the water, because the sharks will get excited when they sense it's there, and they will smell the handle that's in there. So please keep your hands out. Now, all of the sharks that you see here are your sharks, and they get their name from the way they feed. They inhale their food and they push it and then swallow it more or less whole. Most of the sharks will bite into their food and then shake their head from side to side using their top and bottom teeth like saw blades and swallow their food in pieces.
Oh, see what?
Okay, that's the noise you hear is the way he pulls in his food.
Wow.
What
does
that bring to you?
Yeah. Oh, my goodness.
They're cooking fast.
They sucked it in.
Now, how do you chew the fish? Okay, well, you see today, because I'm just demonstrating, it doesn't matter who comes up to be fed. When we feed them, we make sure everybody gets fed.
Okay.
No, we feed them. No, we feed them twice a week. The reason for this is because nut sharks tend to eat whenever food is available. Most sharks will eat a great deal at one time and then go for some time without eating again. With the nut shark, whenever food's available, it will eat. And so in captivity, it tends to overeat and of course it will get fat. So that's why we only feed a nut shark twice a week, because they'll always come and food is there. Now, what I'm going to do is I'm going to go right around the other side and get in and pick one up for you and give you a chance to touch one and to see one up close to get a good look at the mouth.
Look at the face on you. Don't back up.
This is where I'm feeding.
Thank
you. All of the sharks that you see here are quite small. It's because they're babies. Which is good for me, because at least then I can pick one up. But I'm just going to wait till they settle down a bit, because they are a bit excited after the scent of food was over there. Before you all get too excited, I normally pick up the smallest one that's in here.
Smart woman.
Because they're very strong, they're very flexible too. They're made entirely from cartilage, and there's no bones in there, so they're very flexible as well.
How come they don't want to bite you? How come they don't come after you?
Because they realize I'm not food. I don't smell at them like food. I don't look at them like their food.
Yeah, but see, now she has gold on.
Gold doesn't attract sharks. Only food does.
Shiny.
Okay, now he's quite small, like I said, but when I bring him around, his face is going to be right next to yours. So please don't try to pet him or put a finger too close to his head, because he could suck in a finger or two and do a lot of damage, even though he's small. And he is quite mad because he doesn't like to be out of water. But with a nut shark, you can't keep him out of water, and I will explain that as I go around. But first, what I want you to do is just look in his mouth and see his teeth. They are quite small, because nut sharks' teeth are designed for holding and crushing rather than for tearing and biting. But what they lack in size, they make up for in number. And you can see there's three rows to the bottom, three rows to the top. And they all face towards the back, so whoever goes in there does not come out too easily. So I remind you again to keep your fingers down. You can see that his mouth is quite small. And nut sharks have small mouths because of the way they feed. Because of the way they inhale their food. And a small mouth gives them better suction. And don't be fooled by the two projections that look like fangs. They're fleshy appendages called barbels. They're sensory organs and they help the nut shark to locate food. The nut shark spends a lot to the bottom of the ocean, where food is covered by sand anyway, and the type of food that they eat, which are lobsters and clams and fish that stay to the bottom, or animals that live on the bottom. The barbels come in handy to locate the food that's hidden by the sand. And that's what one of the reasons why their eyes are so small. They don't use their eyes as much as other sharks would to locate food. Instead, they use their barbels.
Is this edible?
Yeah, sharks are edible. Yeah.
I don't know. I know you're right.
Okay, now. Well, I can keep that out of water. I can keep the shark out of water for at least a half an hour. Or maybe even longer. We've just never tried it longer. And one of the reasons for this is because of their ability to make motion is on the bottom of the ocean. And they don't need to constantly move like other sharks would. Keep the flowing water over their gills.
They only use it. They only use it actually for. Right now they're very.
This is the milk pump, and these are edible too, but they mature very slow. You can see he's quite old already. The shell is very thick. Yeah, and that's why they don't sell these commercially because they're too small. They will take a lot of years just to make them from fish. They don't bother with them at all. But this is the one you need. When it'll be old, well, they say the younger it is, the more tender it is. But I don't know if I believe that.
It is so.
Yeah.
After a while, it gets tough.
Yeah.
Especially when you want to go practice.
The younger, ones are the better. Yeah.
And it's a young story.
Pick them up.
It is.
Makes a nice salad out of that.
Oh, yeah.
Thank
you.
But
you're not allowed to
talk about turtles now?
I can tell you a little about them. Yeah. Each predator will have about 100 eggs in them. Now, you've got us a lot of eggs, but they have many predators. I'm not the biggest.
This one about his head up over there.
And what happens is, thousands of their eggs are built up because they're so much food. And for the well-traveled beaches, they're first before they have a chance to hatch. Big puppies run over them. If they do hatch, what happens is because there's a lot of hotels coming in and stuff around the beaches, they go at the end of getting confused from the bright lights, and that's when they find a way to the ocean. It's by the shine of the moon on the surface of the water at night time. And even though they may hatch in the day, they'll remain under the sand until the night comes, and then they'll probably, yeah, and then they'll come out from the sand and go to the ocean.
Who's that lady throwing things in
there? San Salvador, I think. I'm not really sure. No, they have a total farm. No, they probably think it's feeding to it.
Yeah.
Hey, Marita. Hi. Yeah. That is a big tree, isn't it?
There's a piano. Spider plants to the right. Yeah?
Gargantuan spider plants. Yeah. There's our hotel, the pink flamingo. Hard-working tribesmen. Another happy native.
Yeah.
Now it's on.
Oh. Well, here we are in our luxurious room. Notice the plush carpeting on the floor. I would walk on this for our bare feet. And the lack of amenities such as phone and TV. Table TV? No. No TV.
But we do have a view.
Which is beautiful, I must say. Come. It's pretty marble tile bathroom. And there you have it.
Thing so small you couldn't change your mind. Very nice. Very nice. And which room is the bathtub?
What bathtub?
Oh.
You don't get a bathtub. So this is in...
This is France.
You are in the Mediterranean.
France. Any bathing beauties in here? Yes? Oh, there's a bathing beauty. Thank you.
you look so French.
That's because I am French.